Hiya! Welcome!
Well, it's the first Funko unboxing on this channel of 2022, and the honours, company-wise, goes to EMP. And this is a peculiar order, this. One pop in here, recent release. Kind of wanted it, but I didn't pre-order it anywhere because I wasn't desperate. It's one that I thought I'd pick up as and when I saw it. And it might have an EMP exclusive sticker on it, even though I didn't think it was an EMP exclusive. And the other thing is definitely supposed to be an EMP exclusive. That's a really weird pickup, that. I'll get into the box and I'll explain, but I'll show you that one last, as it's very impulsive, even more impulsive than other impulsive purchases that I've made. So this total order, which I think I made 2 or 3 days after Christmas. I think the price, and with free postage as well, because I'm a Backstage Club member, it'll be just under, or just over 30. Just under, I think, actually. There seems to be a bit of rattling around in here, I'm not sure why. Obligatory EMP sticker, how many of those have I had over the last couple of years or so? One of their flyers that's got, like, weird wording on it. I think EMP are technically a German company, which will lead me on nicely to the second of these pops, actually. And I think something got lost in translation somewhat there. £5.55 discount. There's the code there. I can't see if that's coming across very well, but use it if you can. Invoice. And here are the pops. I think they've both got the EMP, well, not exclusive, but pre-release stickers on. I do mention a lot on this channel, and partly why I do it is because I know certain other collectors who are really gung-ho about stickers will watch some of my videos, and it's just my way of subtly reminding them that it's not the sticker you're buying it for, it's the actual figure, the dolly, if you will. That one's for you, Tart. Now, it is actually an EMP exclusive sticker on here, rather than it being the EMP pre-release sticker that EMP is sometimes able to put on to special edition pops. I would have assumed this would be available in many more places than EMP, but apparently not. It's number 242 in the Pop Rocks line, and it's Korn's Jonathan Davis. When I heard this was coming out last year, I thought, yeah, I'm not desperate for this, but I'm collecting the Pop Rocks, and if I see it somewhere, I'll pick it up. And with it being an in-box collection, the Pop Rocks for me, when I saw that I could get it for, what, around $13.99 it would have been at EMP with one of their special stickers on, and obviously EMP being a European, I think a German company, you know, that is the closest we get in the continent of Europe to a more interesting sticker than the usual special edition one. But as I say, if you're going to be worried about stickers over getting the actual figure, then you're not really in the collecting game for the right reasons, in my opinion. But it is nice to have a good sticker, so I can see it from both sides. I'm not sure there's any actual Korn logo on here. It's just kind of the one guy from Korn, lead singer, particularly big in like the late 90s. Sort of like new metal, maybe sort of a more darker edge than contemporary acts of the time like Limp Bizkit, etc. Linkin Park as well. I think Korn had more of a kind of maybe slightly gothic or emo sort of feeling to them. This was emo before emo was really a thing, I suppose, in the late 90s. This pop got poor reviews when it was first announced because everyone was saying, oh, that looks nothing like Jonathan Davis. I disagree to an extent. I think as far as Funko goes, it looks enough like him. I've got other pops and you think, well, if they weren't labelled on the box, I'd have no idea who that is. And that'd be the case for this one, I suppose. I wouldn't necessarily know this was the guy from Korn had it not been on the box, but when you know it's him and you look, I don't think it's too bad a likeness, but I'm not a massive Korn fan. I do quite like them. I like some of their stuff. I think I had one of their singles on CD in the 2000s. That would have been Falling Away From Me, I think that was. I picked that up cheap, probably from Andy's Records or somewhere. God, there's a blast from the past, Andy's Records. Well, I'll get Jonathan Davis out, although I think to call this an EMP exclusive, which is what they're doing themselves with that particular box sticker, is a bit of a stretch, as I'm sure this is available elsewhere. I'm glad I got this from EMP rather than elsewhere. So here is Jonathan Davis. He's got this long, I would say just past shoulder length hair. He's got like a purple tracksuit he's got on. Maybe this is a scene from a Korn video. It's not one that I can think of off the top of my head. Or like the realistic looking parting in his hair. You don't get to see many partings like that on Funko Pops. It's a nice touch. Got white stripes on his tracksuit. He's also got kind of matching sneakers, but it's rather than mainly purple and a bit of white, it's mainly white and a couple of purple stripes. So that's Jonathan Davis from Korn, a very nice addition to the Pop Rocks collection. And if I just got this in this order, I think that would have been nice, but I saw something else and it intrigued me because I had no idea who the guy was. I still don't really. But I did do a little bit of reading up, and I'll show you that in a sec. But there we are, back in his box, Jonathan Davis. I'll put him in an ATV pop protector later on. Right, this is the odd one. The sticker on the glam shot on the website, or the app, the sticker looked a little bit different. I think it said something else on it. It was, I don't know, we'll see if this sticker's any different. Opening it up out of the bubble wrap baggie, for some reason this has come in a separate plastic bag, which is odd. So I'll get this open as well, kind of like a bit of double protection really. But the reason I got this particular pop, I looked the guy up and I read about him and I thought, you know what, no one's going to buy this outside of Germany. I'm going to be a little bit different and maybe be one of the very, very few collectors in the UK or outside of continental Europe, you know, Germany, maybe other German-speaking territories like Austria and Switzerland, who will actually get this. And therefore, this might become kind of a rare piece in years to come. The box is different. I'm going to show you because this is an unusual thing. This, it's in the icons line, number 69, and this is a guy called Nossi. Could be pronounced Nosy. Now then, you can see there, we have got a slightly different sticker. It is an EMP, I think it says worldwide exclusive, and then not only the EMP logo, it's got like a double, that might be Warner Media, or Warner Music, I should say, logo. But, yeah. So, Nossi, I can pretty much guarantee that everyone who watches this and comments is not going to know who this guy is, and I won't blame you. I think his real name is something like Jens Nossemann or something like that. He's a German TV presenter. He's also quite big on YouTube and Twitch. I don't think he's done anything in the English language. I had a quick look at his YouTube channel and there's like reactions and stuff and maybe some clips from his Twitch channel as well. And I think he's exclusively in German. He refers to himself, or the media refer to him, as the king of the internet. Okay, bizarre. Interesting back of the box as well, because we get these logos again. Not stuck on either, this proper part of the box. So this is like, I think EMP's first proper EMP exclusive, rather than kind of just whacking a sticker on Jonathan Davis or other EMP exclusives that they've done, or pre-releases, like I've got a Ghost Papa Nihil Pop Rocks figure that's got an EMP pre-release sticker on. I've probably got one or two other EMP stickered pops and I just can't remember offhand. This is like a proper, only ever available, maybe only ever intended to be bought by German people who actually know this Nossi or Nosy guy actually is. But I was just so intrigued by it, and when I looked him up, you know, I learned a little bit about him, that he kind of hosts some TV shows. You know, he was big on YouTube in Germany. He does a lot of stuff on Twitch as well, all in the German language as far as I can tell. He's got his logo there as well, by the way, I forgot to mention. I'm just more intrigued by this box here. Download the Funko app, it tells you to do on the bottom, which, I don't know, maybe that'll come in on all future releases, maybe. Interesting stuff, this. So I'm going to get Nossi out for a bit of a look. Strange, strange pop for my collection, this. I don't really normally like to get pops of people I don't know or people I'm not into, but this one being such a specifically German release, I just thought I have to have this because no one else I know is going to get this. And then if this ends up being quite rare one day in the future and I didn't jump on it when I had the chance, I'm going to regret it. It might not be. This might be something where they've made a load of him and he's not even that popular in his home country. and these end up getting sold off dirt cheap by EMP. I don't know, it could go either way really, but I don't care, to be honest. I'm just happy I got this because I think it's really unusual. So we've got the Nossy fella here with his crown on. Looks like he's got kind of blonde hair. What is that he's holding? I think it's some sort of drink, I think. He's also got like an earpiece in, a wired earpiece. That might be in reference to maybe what he does on TV or maybe what he does on Twitch. I've no idea. Light means it's a bit difficult for me to see some very fine detail on the hands here. But something's going on with his hand. I don't know if it's tattoos or something that he's meant to be holding. Then this like green bottle that's got something on it. Might be some sort of drink, maybe a sponsorship he's got with a German drinks company or something. He's wearing his logoed, would that be jumper? Or maybe a sweater, it could be a jacket actually. I think there's another little logo on the back of it there. How weird is that? I mean, to look at him, you kind of just think, oh, it's just some guy in a crown. But to kind of delve behind who this really is, I think maybe he's probably got a Funko Pop release because he's like more of an internet star, although he does appear on mainstream TV. He's probably like, I don't know, the German equivalent of Dale Winton. Now that's a bit of an old reference because Dale Winton's been dead for years now. You know, I think he's someone who's crossed over from kind of, you know, traditional TV media to being quite big on the internet, or maybe he did the internet thing first. You know, YouTube, and then that enabled him to get a foothold in TV. I honestly don't know. I don't know the guy. I don't speak German, so really I can't go and watch a load of his videos and appreciate them. I think it's nice, really. I like the fact that EMP, a company that aren't American, they're not Canadian, and they're not even pop culture over in Australia. They're German, they're in our continent, and they've actually got a proper German-speaking Funko Pop that fans of his in that country and maybe, you know, one or two surrounding territories will really appreciate, but that people in America, Canada, and certainly here in the UK just aren't really gonna want or appreciate. But I do appreciate it just because of how unusual it is, and this is instantly going to be one of my more slightly out there pieces in my collection now, and I'm glad, I'm really happy that I got this. I'm happy that I got them both from EMP, great delivery from them today. Nossy, or Nosy, I think it's probably Nossy, and Korn's Jonathan Davis. So thank you all for watching, hope you enjoyed this EMP unboxing. I want to give special thanks, as I always do, to my wonderful subscribers and beautiful, spanking, gorgeous patrons. Please see all my Funko affiliate links down in the description text box. Also, there is my Patreon link, my Facebook group link. There's an affiliate link for contents insurance from Urban Jungle. All good stuff for you to check out. I'm going to go now. I'm going to put Jonathan Davis, EMP exclusive, supposedly, although I still have some doubts about that. But at least it means we get the nice EMP sticker, hashtag sticker whore. And this one with an even more unusual and brand new EMP and Warner, possibly, I'm not sure, sticker there. But the worldwide exclusive Nossy Funko Pop. Wow. Still can't get over what an unusual release this is. But I'm glad it happened because he is now in my collection. And I do hope that all of you will join me again next time for my next Funko Pop unboxing. Cheers, everyone. See ya!